Hello students, welcome back to the channel, and this is the video of class 9 biology. And as you know, we were studying chapter 2, which is tissues, and in that chapter we studied about the plant tissues as well as the animal tissues. And here this is the video of revision and of that chapter, and we will solve some multiple choice questions to revise this chapter. So let's begin. The first question is, which of the following tissues has dead cells? So we have studied about the plant tissues, and in that plant tissues there are given some options, and from which you have to opt the type of tissues which has dead cells. So the options are parenchyma, sclerenchyma, colenchyma, and epithelial tissue. So you know that parenchyma, sclerenchyma, and colenchyma, these are the plant tissues, and epithelial tissue is a kind of animal tissue. So here you have to opt the tissues which contain dead cells. So you know that the sclerenchymatous tissue of the plant body has dead cells, and they are found in the bark of the trees. So the correct option is sclerenchyma. Question number 2, find out the incorrect sentence. You have to opt the incorrect sentence. So first statement is, parenchymatous tissues have intercellular spaces. Colenchymatous tissues are irregularly thickened at corners. Apical and intercalary meristems are permanent tissues, and meristematic tissues in its early stage lack vacuoles. So here you know that parenchymatous tissues have intercellular space. The cells in the parenchymatous tissue, they have the intercellular spaces, the space between the cells. So this is the true statement. Colenchymatous tissues are irregularly thickened at the corner. You know that the cells which are found in the colenchyma, they are irregularly thickened. They are thickened at the corner. So this is the correct statement. And the third statement is, apical and intercalary meristems are permanent tissues. So you know that the apical and intercalary meristems are not the permanent tissues. So this is the correct statement. Sorry, incorrect statement. This is the incorrect statement. So this is the right option for this question. Apical and intercalary meristems are permanent tissues. This is the wrong statement. Meristematic tissue in its early stage lack vacuole. This is right. The cells which are found in the meristematic tissue, they do not have vacuoles. Question number 3. Girth of stem increases due to. Girth means diameter. The diameter of stem increases due to which meristem? Apical meristem, lateral meristem, intercalary meristem, vertical stem meristem. So you know that there are three types of meristematic tissue found in the plants, and two types of growth, and that is found in the plants. One is primary growth and second is secondary growth. So secondary growth increases the girth of the stem. In the secondary growth, the diameter of the stem and root increases, and that is because of the lateral meristem. So the correct answer is lateral meristem. It is responsible to increase the diameter, means girth of the stem. Next question is, which cell does not have a perforated cell wall? So perforated cell wall means the holes and openings found in the cell wall. Okay. So in the cell wall, the openings are there, pits are there, that is called perforated cell wall. So tracheids, companion cells, seed tubes, vessels. So these are the cells found in the plant body, and you know that tracheids are the cells which are found in the xylem, and they have perforated cell wall. They have holes in their walls. Companion cells, other cells which are found in the phloem, they do not have perforated cell wall. Sieve tube, you know that in sieve tube, the अपर एंड लोअर सेल वॉल हैज़ द परफोरेशन हैज़ एन ओपनिंग्स. वेसल्स ऑल्सो कंटेन द ओपनिंग. वेसल्स ऑल्सो कंटेन द होल्स एंड ओपनिंग्स इन देयर वॉल. सो ओनली द कंपेनियन सेल्स हियर इफ दे डू नॉट हैव परफोरेटेड सेल वॉल. सो द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन बी. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. Intestine absorb the digested food material. What type of epithelial cells are responsible for that? Stratified squamous epithelium, columnar epithelium, spindle fiber, cuboidal epithelium. So the in the intestine, the digested food get absorbed. So what type of epithelial cells are there? So the cells which are present in the small intestine, that is columnar epithelial cells. Columnar epithelial cells are the cells which are found in the small intestine and they absorb the digested food into the blood. Next question is, while doing work and running, you move your organs like hands, legs, etc. Which among the following is correct? Smooth muscles contract and pull the ligament to move the bones. Smooth muscle contract and pull the tendons to move the bones. And skeletal muscle contract and pull the ligament to move the veins. Skeletal muscles contract and pull the tendon to move the bones. So we move our body part with the help of muscles and bone. So the muscles which move with by our conscious will, they are called skeletal muscles. So here we will see the skeletal muscles and attachment. Skeletal muscles are found attached on the bones. So there are two tissues. There is a tissue which connect the skeletal muscle with the bone, which is called tendon. So here the correct option is skeletal muscles contract and pull the tendon to move the bones, because tendons are the connective tissue which connect the skeletal muscles with the bones. So the correct option is option 4. Now question number 7. Which muscles act involuntarily? Striated muscles, smooth muscles, cardiac muscles, skeletal muscles. So your smooth muscles are the muscles which act involuntarily, means you do not have conscious control over them. You cannot move it according to your conscious will. So smooth muscles are the involuntary muscles which do not act according to your conscious will. And as well as, you know that the cardiac muscles also, they do not under your conscious control. So here second and third is the right, which is given in option B. Now question number 8. Meristematic tissues in plants are. So you know that in plants there are two kind of tissues, meristematic and permanent tissue. Meristematic tissues are those tissues which are responsible for the growth of the plants. So here it is asking that about the meristematic tissues. Meristematic tissues are localized and permanent. They are not limited to certain regions, localized and dividing cells growing in volume. So localized and the meristematic tissues are localized and dividing cells. They are located at certain place. So you can say that they are the localized and dividing cells. Means they have the capacity of cell division. Now question number 9. Which is not a function of epidermis? Protection from adverse condition, gaseous exchange, conduction of water, transpiration. So you know that the epidermis is the made up of epithelial tissue. Epidermis are the tissues found in the plant's body, which is made up of epidermal cells, and they have so many functions, and the main function is protection from adverse condition, conduction of water, gaseous exchange and transpiration. So which is not a function of epidermis. So epidermis protect from adverse condition because it is the protective tissue, and it also help in the so the correct option is here the which is not a function of epidermis. The correct option is transpiration. The cells of epidermis, they are covered by the layer of cuticle over the plant's body, and that's why they cannot lose the water and they do not help in the transpiration. Next, select the incorrect statement. Blood has matrix containing protein, salt and hormone. Two bones are connected with ligament. Tendons are non-fibrous tissue and fragile. Cartilage is a form of connective tissue. So here you know that blood has a matrix which is known as plasma, and it contains protein, salts and hormones. So this is the correct statement. Statement 2 is two bones are connected with the ligament. Yes, this is true. And option 4, cartilage is a form of connective tissue. This is a truth. This is a true statement. This option 3, tendons are non-fibrous. This is incorrect because tendons contain the fibers. They are the fibrous tissue. So the option 3 is the correct statement, correct option for this question. Question number 10. Now we'll see the question number 11. Cartilage is not found in. Where is the cartilage not found? Ear, nose, larynx, kidney. So you know that your external ear is made up of cartilage. The tip of the nose also having the cartilage. In larynx, the C-shaped cartilaginous rings are there which make our windpipe. Kidney do not have cartilage. So the correct option is kidney. Question number 12. Fats are stored in human body as cuboidal epithelium, adipose tissue, bones, cartilage. So we studied the adipose tissue in the types of connective tissue, and we got that in adipose tissue the fats are stored in its cell, which is called adipocyte. In an adipocyte, the fat is stored, which is the cells of adipose tissue. So fats are stored in human body as adipose tissue. Question number 3. Bone matrix is rich in the bone. The matrix is very hard, and which is the presence of calcium and phosphorus. These two minerals make the matrix of bone so hard. So the correct option is calcium and phosphorus. Question number 4. Contractile proteins are found in. So in which of the tissues the contractile proteins are found? Bones, blood, muscles and cartilage. So you know that the muscles are responsible. They have the characteristic feature of contraction and relaxation, expansion. So the muscles have the contractile protein, which is actin and myosin, which cause the contraction in muscles, and that's how they bring about the movement in our body. So the correct option is muscles. Question number 15. Voluntary muscles are found in which body part the voluntary muscles are found? Elementary canal, limbs, iris of the eye, bronchi of the lungs. So our limbs mean hands and legs. We have the voluntary muscles, means we can move it according to our conscious will. Question number 16. Nervous tissue is not found in brain, spinal cord, tendons, nerves. So nervous tissue is found in our brain also, spinal cord also, and nerves also. In the tendons there is no nervous tissue, so the correct option is tendons. Question number 7. Nerve cell does not contain. So the nerve cells, also called as neuron, is the functional and structural unit of nervous tissue. So the part of neuron you have studied in the chapter, it consists of axon, nerve endings and dendrites. It doesn't have tendon. Tendon is the type of connective tissue. So the correct option is tendon. It is not the part of nerve cell. Question number 18. Which of the following helps in the repair of tissue and fill up the space inside the organ? So options are tendon, adipose tissue, areolar tissue and cartilage. So you studied in the chapter that the areolar tissues are the tissues which help in the repair of tissue and fill up the space inside the organ. So the correct option is areolar. Question number 9. The muscular tissue which functions throughout the life continuously without fatigue. Fatigue means tiredness. So So the tissue is skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle, smooth muscle, voluntary muscle. So which muscular tissue doesn't get tired and it works throughout the life continuously? So the you know that the cardiac muscles, which are found in our heart, and they are the muscles, they work throughout the life and do not get tired. So the correct option is cardiac muscles. Now the next question is, which of the following cells is found in the cartilaginous tissue of the body? So which cell is found in our cartilaginous tissue? Mast cell, osteocytes, basophils, chondrocytes. So in our cartilaginous tissue, which is a kind of skeletal tissue, it contains chondrocytes. So the correct option is chondrocytes. Now the next question is, the dead element present in the phloem is? You know that the phloem is the complex permanent tissue of the plant, and complex permanent tissues are those tissues which have more than one type of cells. So the phloem contains companion cells, phloem fibers, phloem parenchyma, and sieve tubes. So out of these four cells, the which cell is dead element? So you know that the companion cells, parenchyma and sieve tubes, these are the living cells, they are the alive. So these are the living cells. Only phloem fiber are the cells which are dead. So the dead element present in the phloem is phloem fiber. Next question is, which of the following does not lose their nucleus at maturity? So which of the cells which do not lose their nucleus at maturity? Companion cells, red blood cells, vessels, sieve tube cells. So companion cells are found in the phloem which have the nucleus. Except these red blood cells at maturity lose the nucleus. Vessels also become dead and do not have nucleus. Sieve tube cells also, they are the living cells of the plant phloem, but they do not have nucleus. So the correct option is companion cells. These cells are the part of the phloem which contain the nucleus at maturity. Rest of these cells, they do not have nucleus at maturity, they lack it. Next question is, in desert plants, rate of water loss gets reduced due to the presence of cuticle, stomata, lignin, seborrhea. So in desert plants, the upper layer of the plant's body contain a thick coat of cuticle which prevent the loss of water. So in desert plants, the water loss is reduced by the presence of cuticle. Next question is, a nail is inserted in the trunk of a tree at a height of 1 meter from the ground level. After 3 years, the nail will. So there is a plant, and in the trunk of that plant, a nail is being inserted at the height of 1 meter. So after 3 years, the nail will move downward, move upward, remain at the same position, move sideways. So here, because the plants grow from the apical meristem, and the nail will remain at the same position. The nail will remain at the same position because and the upper part of the plant will grow upward, and in the part of that plant, the part of that plant of nail will be at the remain at the same position. So the correct option is at the same position. Now the next question is, parenchyma cells are relatively unspecified and thin-walled. Thick-walled and specialized, lignified, none of these. So you have to tell the characteristic feature of parenchyma cells. Parenchyma cells are found in the plant's body. They are the simple permanent tissue, and they are relatively unspecified and thin-walled. This is the characteristic feature of the parenchyma. It is unspecified and thin-walled. So the correct option is option A. Question number 26. Flexibility in plants is due to? So in plants, the tissue which is known as colon cama. It is the tissue which provide flexibility to the plants due to the irregular thickness in the cell wall. So the correct option is colon cama. Question number 7. Cork cells are made impervious to water and gases by the presence of. So the cork cells which are found in the bark, they become impervious to water and gas by the presence of a substance which is called suberin. The cells of the bark of the tree contain the substance called suberin that block the passage of water and gas. So the correct option is suberin. Next question is, survival of plants in terrestrial environment has been made possible by the presence of. Intercalary meristem, conducting tissue, apical meristem, parenchymatous tissue. The plants which are found on the land, they are called terrestrial plants, and they can survive because of the presence of conducting tissue, which is phloem and xylem. They are very helpful in the transport of the water, mineral and food in the plant's body, and they make easy to survive on the land. Now the next question is, choose the wrong statement. The nature of matrix differ according to the function of the tissue. Fats are stored below the skin and in between the internal organs. Epithelial tissue have intercellular spaces between them. Cells of striated muscles are multinucleated and unbranched. Option C is the incorrect, because epithelial tissues have no intercellular space. No intercellular spaces are found between the cells of epithelial tissue. So this is the incorrect, and which is correct for this question. Rest of the statements are true. The nature of matrix differs according to the function of tissue. As the function of tissue, likewise the matrix are there. Fats are stored below the skin and between the internal organ. This is correct. And cells of striated muscles are multinucleated and unbranched. This is also correct. Here it is asking, choose the wrong statement. So the wrong statement is the option C. Now the last question of this video. The water conducting tissue generally present in gymnosperm is. The water conducting tissue generally present in the gymnosperm, which is. Tracheids. So these are the tracheids. Tracheids are the main water conducting tissue present in the gymnosperm plants. Gymnosperm plants are those plants which have naked seeds. Their seeds are not covered with the inside the fruit. They are called gymnosperm, like Christmas tree. So this is all for this video, and in the next video we'll see the next question and next topic. Thank you.